Here we are again, dear friends, on a chillier night. Is this a strange sight in the sky? And I think it is. That just proves it. Now I shouldn't have had to hit on my light meter. Can you hear me? Can you see me? Can you acknowledge? This is another energy portal in the sky. It changes shape. See? Did it again a couple of times. It is about 10:30 at night, Thursday night, October 24th, a week from Halloween. I just bought my pumpkin today, a little sugar pumpkin. They last longer, you know, if you don't cut them up and make a jack-o'-lantern out of them. They have like a sugar coating. I bought it at Trader Joe's, a couple bucks. A little pumpkin, but I like anything pumpkin, you know. Orange pumpkins, Smashing Pumpkins, the alternative band, Halloween, Orange. Can you see my hand wave? Last time I was talking to you, if you can hear me, you answered my questions. Do you remember me? Can you see me filming you? Okay, now I'm sounding like a total nut. I posted that video like two or three videos ago that said it was responding to me without my light meter, something to that effect, the title said. And this is the exact same area, same sphere in the sky, unless they one was on one relieved the other like on break or something. It doesn't seem to. The only way it responds, if I'm gonna do it now, I touch on the light meter. See, it changed again because it sees the flash facing it, the green flash, which it's probably really small to this thing, but it's bright, you know, you can see it. It responds to light, flashes of light. You know, they got these garbage trucks on the street and they have these blinking lights, and they stopped at a corner or something, or different vehicles, and that work for the city. And I wonder if it responds to those sounds or lights that they give off. Maybe not. Just a thought. So here we are again with another video, people. Posted one today. I will post this by the morning. And the weather not that I'm the weatherman, but I've checked it. It's going to be good for the next 7-8 days. Of course, we're out of the tropical kind of weather, you know, spring and summer. Normally I can take it, but in the city, when it gets hot and it's all this cloudiness, it's not my ideal atmosphere. But it always depends on what we're doing, right? Yeah. So, there's no sense in hitting the light meter too much more. This is at a decent size. Well, I'll do it here. There we go. Got bigger. So, clouds can't do this. They can change shape, but the wind makes them change the shape. It is a little chillier tonight. It's not windy, really. I feel a little wind, but it couldn't make it expand and contract bigger and smaller. So there's your fact. That's a fact, Jack. Is Halloween important to you? Are you all getting dressed up, especially in the New York City area? Are you going to the parade this year, which will be on a Thursday? It'll be much better when it starts the weekend, but that'll be in another, 3 years? 2 years. No, not 1 year. Yeah, Thursday, yeah, next year it'll be Friday. What am I saying? So, that would be better, of course. And not rainy weather. I've gone to the Halloween parade even by myself sometimes. I'm starting to enjoy my company more. I mean, I go to restaurants all the time by myself. Certain events, museum, whatever. But parade is another thing, because these are all strangers. I find people less friendly than they used to be. In general, I'm generalizing. Of course, it depends. You hit a certain crowd, you know, they're super friendly and say, hey, why don't you come with us, or blah, blah, blah. You don't know if there's like horns sprouting on their head, or you can be friendly but be cautious. I might practice black magic or something. My own spiritual protection from demons. I'm not religious, I'm spiritual, very spiritual. Art is very spiritual, what I'm doing right now. You might say, oh, it's just YouTube. No, man, it's spiritual. Never a dull moment doing this. Of course, like I said, I'm always looking for new things. I have a sixth sense for the unusual. Anything in the sky that looks unusual, I'm gonna film it. So I'm pretty much got my sixth gun ready, my camera, and I'm quick on the draw. Because if you're not, you'll miss it. And I have missed a couple of things that just a few seconds. I either didn't bring my camera or didn't come out quick enough, but usually it does. For any of you who love the 70s series Kolchak, the Night Stalker, he was a photojournalist, and he was pretty quick with the camera too, filming all these freaks and monsters, creatures. Yeah, that's kind of a blue color. Lighter blue, the sky's blue. A nice contrast to the darker sky. Well, I'm really poetic tonight. What brought that on? Not every writer's a poet, and not every poet's a writer. You like that, huh? Yeah, that was slick. So that is a building, the side of a building there. Pan out a little. See the clouds above it? Like, yeah, you see the white line? They're misty clouds. They're not thick clouds where this is in no danger of being covered like other nights where I showed you. I have to stop filming because it just covered it all. Red color in it. Let me see. Yeah, tap on the light meter again. Tap on it. Boom. This is Morse code communication. I hope you're as fascinated with it as I am. Smaller. Well, I won't leave it at that. Okay, this is much better. I don't want my followers squinting their eyes, saying, oh man, that was just a drone in the sky. Didn't change shape. You're crazy. Anyone call me that in years, so it must be slipping. What's going on? Can you hear me clearing my throat? I'm turning into a wolf man, a werewolf. This is not a moon, though. A werewolf needs the moon to go into full bloom, to change. It's a circle like the moon, but remember I said that video I did, the moon is not blue. I was just kidding around. It's never blue. If it is, let me know. Show me proof. It's been other colors. And there are no craters on this sphere. This energy sphere portal and it can't be a nebula, although those are really beautiful, but they're way up in space, way up in space. I mean, you need a super telescope from an observatory probably to see them. You never see those with the naked eye in the sky. If you do, please let me know, because I'm gonna think you're bullshitting me. So this one is right outside the front of the building. It's like a block and a half away. This is the other one. Choice of three or four of these, it seems, on a regular basis, so I'll keep sending you different ones or whatever else I find up here in these mysterious skies that aren't planes, that aren't helicopters, that aren't drones, you know? Would you like that? Sure you would. Okay, so, dear friends, that's about it for tonight's vid. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Please keep tuning in. Like, comment, share. It really helps the channel and the algorithm. And with that being said, this is Strange Sights in the Sky, signing out.